Hey y'all. Well, today I'm getting ready for a seafood boil. Hi, kitty. So I've got my bib on. Hungry fat chick. You in my way, kitty? You are. Yeah, I'm gonna move my table there. Yes, I am. Yep. Okay, let me get my table with my seafood boil. Okay, I'm going to show y'all that bib Susan made for me. Oh, I got my shears all the way on the other side there. Okay. Let's see what we got here. Let's see, maybe I might move my butter to the opposite side. I just got butter. Sorry, kitty.
Okay.
I'm just hanging out. New slip pads, but they're annoying. Okay, there we go. All right. Get into first. Wait a minute. Let me move this over just a little bit because y'all still can't see my dang butter. Alright. Alright. Let's see if I remember how to do this. I got some snow crab legs and king crab legs. So, let's see. Oh, they're spiny. Oh, I'm a wimp. Okay. Okay. I've been watching people do this. Fair. Ooh, that's a nice piece of meat. I'm get it my butter here. You know, I'm just a simple girl. Squirt lemon. Oh, man. Lemon and butter. Ooh-wee. Oh, it don't get no better than that. I dig that hunk of meat out of there. Oh man. Oh yes. Mm-hmm. I got me a pound of snow crab and a pound of king crab. Oh yeah, okay. More potatoes. Dip in the butter. All right. I'm gonna eat every little bit. I'm trying to take this lipstick off before I get it smeared all over my face, because I feel like now that I've talked about that, that's what's going to happen. A little piece of sausage I boiled in the crab boil. It's nice and soft. Oh, that snow crab is good too. Excuse me. I got crab in my teeth. Oh no, I got corn in my teeth. I can tell this is gonna be a long video, so y'all just hang in there. Oh, yeah. Little pieces of meat from them snow crabs. It's not as humongous as the king crab. But it's just as delicious in my opinion. Yeah, it was on sale. So I got a pound of each. So I was like, yeah, let's do this. Oh yeah. Oh, so good. There we go. Where's that? Oh, there's that. Use that as a pick. I know I've got butter on my chin. I don't care. The dog's been outside for hours. He's refusing to come in. I have called him. I have held the door open, the little door flap. I'm like, okay, whatever, just stay out there for a little while. I figure he'll come in when he gets ready. That's what he did yesterday. Susan is in Reno right now. She just went to visit her new grandbaby. She has a grandson. Shoot. I see where it went. It landed on my lens cap. He'll wolf a little bit every now and then. And I'll go over there. And he'll just be a little, you know what. And he'll be like, nope, not coming in. And he'll walk away. Speak of the devil. So, I'm going to have to pause for a second. and go see if he'll come in. I don't think he's barking at me. I think he's just random barking out there. He's barking at the neighbors. Hi, kitty. But I'm holding down the fort here as best as I can. He did good last night though. He didn't have too much of a problem with his mama gone. He behaved himself. Ooh, old egg. Buttery egg. I got my hair in my mouth. Oh, somebody ate too fast. This is an indication that I need some water. Why does these have to be so spiny? Ow! Oh, yeah. Okay. So, I don't know why the dog doesn't want to come in. Is he mad at me? I don't think he's mad at me. I think he's just mad at the situation. Oh, I think that was a little woof at me. Me trouble anyway, as far as coming in when I call him. He comes in easy for his mama, though. He's just obstinate with me. It's funny because he's not always like that. He's just finicky. And it's like one day he's one way, another day he's another way. But, I don't know. I'm not gonna take it personal. Okay, that is a big old piece of meat. Women don't squirt everywhere except on the meat. Wow, that is good. Oh, wow. Ouch. I'm gonna cut my hands on these things. Oh, and before y'all worry about the doggy out there, just know that after a little while, even if I let him just bark for a little while, like if he just straight up starts barking, like say he ignores me and walks away for a couple of times, and then I'm just like, okay, well, you just bark for a little while. You'll get over it and you'll come in. Well, after about 10 minutes or so of him barking, he'll just come in. He'll be like, okay, well, I guess nobody's going to get up and answer my call. So I'll just come in. Knowing that he could come in by himself the whole time. I love the little guy, but he's playing a game. He's playing a little game. He's a little doggy head game. Ooh, excuse me. Man, am I eating all my crab? And I got one piece of king crab left, and two snow crab cluster. That would have been good if I'd have fried it up on the stove, but I just put it in with the boil. And I used Old Bay. I grew up on Old Bay. My grandparents spent some time with me living in Maryland. Always. Well, there and other places. And they love to go crabbing. They catch some blue crabs. Oh man. Yeah, I remember going crabbing too. But not in any of them places. Not up on the northeast coast. I'm not too far north. Just around the Carolinas and Maryland. But, we used to go crabbing down in Grand Isle. We'd have some crab traps. And he'd go buy, my granddaddy, he'd go buy, like, turkey necks. And use those as bait. Catch crabs and then do a crab boil that night. It was always fun. I'm gonna have to do some blue crabs. I know when y'all think seafood boil, Y'all think these king crabs and snow crabs and all this stuff. And the mussels and the shrimps and stuff like that. But, and I think them blue crabs, Gulf shrimp and things like that. And that's the kind of stuff that makes me happy. I can't get no meat out of that. I'm gonna try. All right. No, I'm not very talkative in this one. This is a lot of work here. Yeah, eating is work. I guess it is, though. Under these kinds of circumstances, it sure is. Yeah. Found a show that I used to watch on Amazon Prime. And I can't for the life of me right now figure out where I left off. I'm watching Teen Wolf. Show. It's cute. Well, I mean, you know. It's been on for a while now. Getting on this table. Oh. Okay. But yeah, so I'm trying to figure out where in the heck I left off. Oh, shoot. Just fixing to open that. Ooh. That's pretty, already cracked. Oh man, I'm so sidetracked here. Can't remember what the heck I'm trying to say. Anyway, I can't find out where I left off in that show. Digging around in season 7. And Prom has up to season 9. And so far, I think I've seen all the episodes that I'm looking at. In season 7, but I'm looking at the little write-ups on all the episodes and they don't sound familiar, but I'm watching the episode and I'm like, oh, okay, Y'all remember that. Okay. Okay. Yeah, it's good. Man, come on. Let go. Another show I'm watching. It's on Netflix that I'm liking a lot. It was that Lock and Key show. I didn't think I was gonna like it because it looked too much like a kid show, but no, I watch kid shows. I'm a big kid at heart. And of course, I liked it. What I've seen so far. I'm really trying to eat up all this seafood because trash has to go out tonight. You want some? No. I'm gonna get you a big piece of meat. He's just laughing at me. Okay. Okay. You sure I couldn't tempt you with this? No? Okay. Mm-hmm. Hey, dog, come in. I'm really into this. No time to chat today. Okay. Getting close here. Maybe some leftovers, some leftover potatoes and corn. That's okay. What are you doing over there? I'm getting hung up and stuff over there, kitty. Got all my cords hanging over there. I'm gonna be in trouble. In kitty bondage. What is she? Oh, I dropped a napkin on her. Oh, yes. So who all listens to Ozzy? I've been listening to Ozzy's new album, Ordinary Man, on repeat on Amazon. I get to listen to it with my Amazon Prime for free, which I have every intention of buying it when it becomes available. I'm thinking of doing the pre-order. Because it's only like $10 for the MP3. That's how I do it, because, you know, I don't want a bunch of CDs or DVDs or whatever hanging around. I prefer that. Man, was that it? Shoot. Save the best for last. Let me get that meat nugget. Broke it up. And I couldn't tell you what my favorite song is on that album, but right now the earworm is Holy for Tonight. And y'all know my thoughts on Christianity, but for some reason all these songs alluding to Christianity end up being my favorite songs. Like Led Zeppelin's Stairway to Heaven. Oh, did y'all see that? It just popped right out of there. Well. My butter's thickening up. Notice I didn't even care about lemon. Oh man. Oh. Yeah, I'm gonna have to cut that one. Oh yeah, so me and Ozzy go way back. I listened to Ozzy when I was like 13, 14, 15. Got that. I don't know if y'all see that, but a little homemade Ozzy tattoo on my arm. When Thomas met me years ago, he saw that tattoo. He was like, that was a perfect indicator that I was straight out the trailer. He was absolutely correct. I mean, I didn't grow up in a trailer. I grew up in a 4-bedroom brick home, but at the time, he would have been correct. Not that that means anything. It's just a kind of a figure of speech. Stereotypical. Y'all know that saying. And I didn't take it personally. I was like, yeah, rock on. Piece of sausage. Okay, when it boiled, it just busted open. Now I'm full. Mm. Okay. I am done. Oh, Lord have mercy. Oh, well, notice I left the cover on the chair in case of butter or crab splatter. But, wow. Oh, I've got corn all in my teeth. Oh, I hate it. Oh. Oh, mercy. Oh, man. That was really good, y'all. Whew. I thank you all for joining me. I'm gonna have to do the seafood bowl thing more often. That was pretty far out and fabulous. hope y'all had fun too. And I will see you next time. Bye now.